Good morning. How are you all children? Hope you are all happy, fine, safe, healthy at home. I am Vandana Shetty and I am an English faculty. Triveni Public School has provided an online teaching platform to involve and invoke the quest of education and learning you have in you. Learning is a continuous process, isn't it? Learning will never stop. So now, learning has been at the ease of your doorstep. And we are all back with more of learning for you all. Today, let's start the new session in English for grade 6, Leaving the Valley by Malala Yousafzai. This is an extract taken from I Am Malala, which is an autobiography written by Malala Yousafzai herself. What do you mean by autobiography? Autobiography is nothing but life story of a person written by himself or herself. Here, Malala has written her life story in her book, I Am Malala. So, here this lesson is an extract from this book, I Am Malala. Now let us know more about Malala. Who was Malala? Where was she born? So, here are some details of Malala for you. Malala was born on 12th July 1997 in Mingora, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Northwest Pakistan. She was an activist for education of girls and women. She was really passionate about becoming a doctor, but her father inspired her to become an educational activist. At a very small age, she started speaking about education for girls and she came into the limelight. In 2012, she was attacked by the Taliban. In fact, she was shot when she was returning back from her school in her school years. Today, she is internationally recognized as an advocate for the education of women. So, with all this information about Malala, let's start this lesson, Leaving the Valley. This lesson, as I told you, is an extract from the story I Am Malala. Here, she describes her feelings when she was about to leave her valley, Swat Valley, where she lived in. Let us learn more about this lesson now. Before I start the lesson, I expect each one of you to keep your textbooks open and also have a pencil handy with you. Whenever I read the text, you will have to focus on the pronunciation and the intonation of the voice and the voice modulation too. Now, you have to mark the hard words, whichever you encounter when I read. Okay, I think you are clear with the instructions. Let's start the lesson. Yes. Leaving the home felt like having my heart ripped out. I stood on our roof looking at the mountains, the snow-topped Mount Airy. I looked, the fruit of our apricot tree might be eaten by someone else this year. Everything was silent, pin drop silent. There was no sound from the river or the wind. Even the birds were not creeping. I wanted to cry because I felt in my heart that I might never see my home again. Here, in this paragraph, Malala explains about her feelings, what she feels when she was about to leave the Swat Valley. She stayed in the Swat Valley and they were forced to leave the place because of the Taliban. Because Taliban did not allow girls to attend schools at that time. All the schools were shut down. So they didn't have any other option other than leaving the place. When they were leaving the place, she describes her feelings. She says that she felt as if her heart was ripped out. What do you mean by ripped out? Ripped out means torn into pieces, two pieces. So she feels her heart was ripped out. She stands at the top of the roof, looking at the mountains. Which was a mountain which was there then? Elam. She stands there at the top of a house looking at Mount Elam, which was snow covered. She also says that she would not be able to eat the apricot fruits from the apricot trees which she had, which she used to always have. As a child, it is common to have such a behavior. And she also explains about the environment which was there. She says everything was silent. She says it was pin drop silent. What is pin drop silence? The pin drop silence is nothing but you should be able to hear the sound of even a pin which is dropped on the floor. So quiet, so silent the environment was. She is very nicely describing the environment here. She says there is no sound from the river too. And even there was no sound of the wind breezing. She says the birds were also not chirping. So everything around her was so quiet. She wanted to cry. Again, because she felt that she might not return back to her home native again. Next, let us move to the second paragraph. Everything I could not imagine happening had happened. I thought my school would not close. It had. I thought we would never leave Swat, and we were just about to. I thought Swat would be free from the Taliban one day and we would rejoice. But now I realize that might not happen. So here in this paragraph, she speaks about what all she thought and what all has not happened. She had thought that she never thought that she would be leaving her hometown. But they were forced to leave the place. She also says that she never thought her school will close. Did you all ever think that your school will be closed like this for the lockdown? I don't think so. Even this was never expected from you all, isn't it? Same way, Malala also felt that the schools will never be closed, but all the schools were closed. She thought she will never leave the Swat Valley, but even that had happened because of the Talibans. She also thought that the Swat Valley will be free of the Talibans. But that never happened. She thought she would be very happy when it would be free from the Talibans. But even that has not happened. So there are many things which she thought would happen and has not happened, and it has broken her heart here in the second paragraph. Now let us move on to the third paragraph. I think you are all marking the hard words as and when I am reading it. Please do it. Keep a pencil handy with your children. I started to cry. It was as if everyone had been waiting for someone else to start. My cousin's wife, Honey, started weeping. Then all of us were crying. But my mother was very composed and courageous. So in the third paragraph, she explains about the emotions. The way they all started crying, it normally happens with us, isn't it? So when we see someone crying, even we feel like crying and we enter into the situation in which they are. Even we start crying. The same thing has happened here. She started to cry. Then she saw her cousin's wife, Honey, who started weeping. Looking at her, all started weeping in the house. But her mother was the only one who was very composed. What do you mean by composed? One who controls her feelings. She was very composed and she was very courageous. Means she was very strong and she never cried. Next paragraph. I put all my books and notebooks in the school bag and then packed another bag of clothes. I couldn't think straight. What do you mean by couldn't think straight? Was not able to think clearly because one was overcome with emotions. So she was completely emotionally outbursted that she couldn't think properly. She put all her books and notebooks into the school bag and then packed another bag of clothes. She was not able to judge things properly at all. I took the trousers from one set and the top from the other. So, she was in a stealth state. So what she has done, she has taken the trousers of one set and the top from another. So, I had a bag of things that did not match at all. I didn't take any of my school awards or photos or personal belongings as we were travelling in someone else's car. And there was little room. My mother also said, I must leave my school valuable item had been our TV, a fridge, a washing machine. We didn't lead a life of luxury. We persons prefer to sit on floors rather than chairs. So here, in this paragraph, she speaks about how they packed the things and what all the things they had in them. Here she says, she puts all of the bags and notebooks into the school bag. Then she packs another bag where she has all the clothes. She couldn't judge properly. She was in a confused state. She took the trouser of one set and the top of another set. So she had a bag which was fully mixed up with unwanted things which didn't suit each other. And she was also not allowed to take the awards which she had got from the school, the photos or some personal belongings of hers. Because they were all travelling in someone else's car. They were not so rich enough to have own a car. They had to travel with someone else. So her mother also said to leave the school bag behind. They had to leave the school bag behind. And she also describes her house here. She says, we didn't have many luxurious items. We used to sit on the floor and eat. They didn't have a dining table or all the luxuries what we have as of now. She didn't even have a laptop or some jewelries. They had the only belongings they had, assets they had here, was a TV, a fridge and a washing machine. So few items they had in their house, but they had to leave the place because of the Taliban's. So this completes the fourth paragraph. So I think the hard words and the new words which you have come across this month. So I expect you to take out a dictionary, search for the meanings. That is an activity which is given to you. Search for the meanings of all these words and write it down in a sheet of paper. Along with that, I also expect you to do some research on Malala's life. So you can use Google resources for this. You can just take up some incident. You get it in YouTube also. You can just refer them and write a composition about Malala. I think this will be the activity for this lesson. Very soon I will be continuing with this lesson in the next class. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.